हेलो एवरीवन, सो आई एम बैक अगेन विथ अ वेरी गुड बुक रिव्यू एंड समरी ऑफ द बुक, सो दैट यू डोंट नीड टू रीड द बुक एंड यू विल गेट द मेन पर्पस ऑफ दैट बुक थ्रू दिस वीडियो ओनली. दिस इज सी वृंदा वखारिया, स्टूडेंट बाई नेचर, सी ए बाई प्रोफेशन एंड योर ट्यूटर, योर मेंटर, योर गाइड बाई पैशन. सो टूडे आई एम हियर विथ अ बुक रिव्यू. द बुक नेम इज रिच हैबिट्स. ऑथर ऑफ द बुक इज थॉमस सी कैरली. दिस बुक इज वेरी शॉर्ट एंड सिंपल. It contains 67 pages only, including cover page, including content, including introduction part. So at all you have to read only 67 pages. Now to take you to the journey of this book, a man called J.C. Jobs was doing a work as a tax consultant and his wife need to do a surgery, but they cannot afford it by that time, so they decided to delay the surgery till the tax season. That means when JC Jobs earn more money and then only they can afford to do surgery. In between, JC Jobs had lost his wife, and after she passed away, he was very nervous. One of his client came to him to ask his suggestion, why even after putting so much efforts in his business, why that person could not earn more. So while searching the answer of that question, JC Jobs interviewed many his clients who were so-called successful, who were rich in their business. So during that inquiry, JC Jobs came with a list of the good habits that he called rich habits, which makes a person rich by doing it in the routine of that habit. So let's quickly see what are that 10 rich habits. So the first rich habit is, I will form good daily habits and follow this good daily habits each and every day. In this habit, what you have to do is you have to list down all your bad habits that you are hesitant with, and gradually you should start moving, you should start shifting your that bad habit into one good habit. Say for example, I see a television for almost 2 to 3 hours at a night. This is your bad habit because you are spending more time on watching television. So you have to convert your this bad habit, and you have to reduce the hours on television from 2 to 3 to maximum 1 hour. This way gradually you come to know what are your bad habits of the day and how you can convert that bad habit into good habit, and then gradually you have to leave that good habit as your routine part. The second rich habit listed down is, I will set goal for each day, for each month, for each week, for each year, and a long-term goal. I will focus on my goals each and every day. Firstly, start planning your goal for a day, that this much task you have to complete by the end of this day. Then a weekly goal, then a monthly goal. Say if you are an insurance selling person, then you have to make a goal that by the end of this month you will sell at least 5 insurance plans. So that's your monthly goal. Then a goal of a year, that means by the end of this year you will grow your business by this much percent. So that's your yearly goal. And then long-term goal, you want to buy house in next 5 years, you want to purchase this car, a specific car, within this much years, you want to grow your business by this much percentage at this level. So these are your long-term goals. And for achieving, for focusing on that goals, the author has also suggested to make a visualization board. That means what you want to achieve in life in long term, you should put a picture in front of you so that you can see that frequently and your mind grabs it. So that's the way to focus on your goal and to achieve your goal. Third rich habit is, I will engage in self-improvement each and every day. That means in whatever field you are working or doing a job, you have to engage yourself in self-improvement. That means, say if you are a tax consultant, then you must spend at least half an hour daily in reading some journals, in some magazines, which gives you more knowledge about your field, which gives you more knowledge about your taxes, about how to save tax, about how to grow money, how to invest. So that's your core area. Like if you are in industrial construction, then you must read journals which contains articles about the construction, and that way you can suggest more to your clients, and it will ultimately grow your business, grow your work. Fourth rich habit is, I will devote part of each day and every day in caring for my health. Health is wealth. So agar aapko wealth create karni hai, then you must have to analyze your health as well. और इस चैप्टर में ऑथर ने बात की है कि आपको हेल्दी ईटिंग पे ज़्यादा फोकस करना है, और साथ ही साथ एक हैबिट बनानी है दैट एटलीस्ट फॉर 30 मिनट्स यू विल एक्सरसाइज डेली, वीकली एटलीस्ट फॉर 4 डेज यू वर्कआउट. फिफ्थ रिच हैबिट इज, आई विल डिवोट पार्ट ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी डे टू फॉर्मिंग लाइफ लॉन्ग रिलेशनशिप. Even if you are earning much, but there is no meaning if there are no people to hang up with you, right? To celebrate your victory, to celebrate your wealth, you need persons in your life. So creating lifelong relationship is also very important. In this chapter, author has also explained one example that as a salesperson, you have to see your services after sales, and that way you can create long-term relationship with your clients also. So it is very much important that you create your relationship, group of persons in your life which are there with you at any time you need them, and for that you have to maintain that relationship. And for that, author suggests that at least for 5 minutes call one person, talk with them, say thank you, or at least be connected with them to create a lifelong relationship. Can't we take out 5 minutes of our day? Sixth is, I will live each and every day in a state of moderation. Now, what does mean by moderation? Here the author says that as a successful person, or to become a successful person, you have to keep your mind in state of moderation. You cannot be sad, very sad. You cannot be so much happy. You have to control your emotions, and for that you have to control your mind, you have to control your thoughts. And that way you will be in state of moderation. Even if you are in loss, that's okay. Prepare your mindset that you will recover someday. And if you are at gain, then it's okay. These days will also pass. So be calm and stay in moderation. Seventh rich habit is, I will accomplish my daily task each and every day. I will adopt a do it now mindset. जो भी काम आप हाथ में लेते हो ना, उसको ही ख़त्म करो. Don't delay your work. This habit will also make you effective. This habit will also save your time, and by that habit you can do more the next day because you have already completed your to-do list in that day itself. Eighth habit is, I will engage in rich thinking each and every day. By this, author says that of course you need to be positive in every way. In this chapter, author focuses on affirmations and visualization techniques to drive and alter your mindset. So you have to give affirmations to yourself to think rich. Affirmations like, yes, I am lucky, I am successful, I make $3,000 a year, say for example, I am senior executive in my company if it's your goal, I love working with others, I am confident, I call my parents every week. So these are the affirmations that you need to give to yourself to set your mindset in a positive manner, in a rich manner. Reach habit number 9 is, I will save 10% of my gross income every paycheck, and this should be your habit to save at least 10% from your income every year, and this will definitely make you rich because this will create passive income for you. So investment in a good manner should be your one of the basic habit. It should not be income minus expense is equal to saving. It should be income minus saving and the balance should be your expense. So this is the 9th habit and I am really focusing on it. Habit number 10 is, I will control my thoughts and emotions each and every day. This is the conclusion of all the rich habits. So, here author says, successful people are the masters of their thoughts and emotions. They do not fall prey to anger, jealousy, acceptability, sadness, or any other petty emotions. They cast out all bad thoughts and emotions. So that's all about this 10 rich habits. Try to accomplish these rich habits in your schedule, in your routine, and see what your life brings for you. I hope you like the summary of this book and please try to follow these 10 rich habits for your self-improvement, for your self-growth. So see you with the next video. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.